In this chapter, we're going to be talking about business processes and how those business processes can be affected by information systems. The book is going to use the Gear Up Company as its example of a system process, so you do want to pay attention to the discussions of Gear Up. The first part of our discussion in the textbook in this chapter talks about what is a business process. Well, a business process, as the book defines it, is a network of activities for accomplishing a business function. Well, basically what that means is that's the overall picture of how we do things. For instance, you know, how do we sell to our customers? How do we buy inventory? How do we pay our bills? It's a little bit different than a procedure. A procedure would be the steps taken within the process. So it is important to understand the processes that the business takes in order to accomplish its functions. As for why employees need to understand business processes, that's fairly intuitive. But having an overall view of how things get done within the company helps employees become better employees. And in the Gear Up example, obviously they need to understand better how the processes work so that they can work within the processes better themselves. On this slide, and also in the textbook on page 28, you have this business process model. And the BPMN stands for Business Process Modeling Notation. There's an international standard for the symbols that are used, and the symbols will be explained on the next slide here. But notice that this model shows the processes from vendor to customer. It's organized in something, as the book explains, something called swim lane. And if you'll notice that each activity or each entity has its own lane, kind of like the Olympics when they're swimming here. But notice that the Gear Up's processes only include the middle three. There's a starting point and an ending point for Gear Up. However, the entire process for Gear Up also includes two things that they don't control, the vendor and the customer. The only thing that Gear Up really controls are just those three processes that you see there. However, the entire process does include both the vendor and the customer. If we didn't have vendors and customers, we wouldn't be able to complete this process. This slide and the page in the book explains the process model symbols. Now, just a heads up here, you will have to include a process model with both your business MIS review and your group project. Now, the book mentioned that you can do this very easily in Visio, a program called Visio. If you don't have access to the program Visio, you can come pretty close by using Microsoft Word and just using the Insert Shapes feature.
This slide and the corresponding chart in the book, of course, give an example how information systems can be revised to improve efficiency. Now, if you pay really close attention, you'll notice that before there were two different databases or data repositories in which the buyers and the operations maintained separately. And in the revised, the improved version, they share a single database. And that's actually going to be crucial to a lot of what you might find in your redesign. Sharing information eliminates duplication and accuracy errors and all kinds of things. And we're going to cover that quite a bit further when we talk about databases.
This slide and the corresponding page in the book reintroduce us to the information systems model. Remember that information systems is made up of five components: hardware, software, data, procedures, and people. Now in this slide, we see how this actually works. Data or information is the bridge between the hardware, the computer side, and the human side. And as the textbook explains, the software are the instructions for the computer. The procedures are instructions for the people, and the data is the bridge between them, and the data, both the people and the computer use the data to make decisions. They process that data, and they use the data. Theoretically, the definitions of data and information are different. Data, sometimes referred to as raw data, is difficult to interpret and almost useless alone by itself. Information is data that makes sense. It's presented in a way that makes it easier to make decisions and understand the bigger picture. For example, If we just knew that within the Gear Up Company, John Smith earned $17 an hour and Mary Jones earned $25 an hour, that's data, but it isn't very useful. It doesn't really tell us much about the bigger picture. On the other hand, if we manipulate that data process, do some averaging and summing, and we found out that the average employee wage for females in one particular group is lower than males, well, that's very useful information. So data is just information that makes sense and makes it easier for us to understand things. I'm sure you've heard the term that we are living in the information age. And what that really means is that we are really inundated with information. And so here are some characteristics that make quality information. Number one, it's got to be accurate. Obviously, information that isn't accurate is no good. You've all heard the acronym garbage in, garbage out. We don't want garbage. We want accurate information. Timely. If we need to change our pricing, I don't need to know about the sales 3 years ago. I need to know what's happening right now. Relevant, same thing. It has to pertain to the subject. The other one that might kind of surprise you here is the just barely sufficient. We don't want to give too much information, and really this will vary depending on your audience. Maybe you have the CEO that says, you know, just give me the bottom line. In that case, that would be barely sufficient information. On the other hand, perhaps lower level managers might want some more of the details, but just enough, not everything, just enough to get by. And of course, it has to be worth the cost. If it costs thousands of dollars to generate one simple report that really doesn't justify the cost, well, it's not worth doing at that point.